Hello and welcome to PLC programming using CODESYS YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate briefly a project that three of my undergraduate students, Miraz, Damir and Amir, have done for their industrial automation course. It's called as Computer Vision with CODESYS and Python, and the aim is to have a conveyor belt on which bottles will be transported. There is a simulated proximity sensor to detect that a bottle has reached a specific position where there is also a camera located. Then the camera is used to take a photo of the bottle and provide it to Python code, which is written to determine whether there is a label attached to the bottle or not. If there is no label, then the bottle will be ejected. Otherwise, it will continue moving on the conveyor, as you see in the example demos here. Now let us have a look at the different components of the project. In the CODESYS environment, we have the main code developed in ladder logic. The declared variables include the booleans, integers, timers, counter, and an instance of a movement function block. The movement function block itself is developed using structured text. It has four input variables, two output variables, which determine the location of the bottle on the screen, and two internal timer variables. As the name suggests, this function block is used to control or simulate the movement of the bottles on the conveyor belt. The detection of the label on the bottle is performed using Python, and in order to have communication between Python and CODESYS, we need to configure CODESYS as an OPC server. To do so, a simple configuration is included in the project where the variables to be exchanged with Python are selected, as you can see here. On the Python side, here we have the main code where three functions, grabFrame, checkLabel, and classifyCameraImage are used. As for the images, there are two types, labeled and unlabeled. A random function is used to generate zeros and ones randomly and to determine if the bottle has a label or not. Then in the classified camera image, the original image, which is in RGB, is converted into grayscale in order to use it in adaptive thresholding, which uses binary thresholding as the main method. This creates a contrast between the ground and the object. After finding all the contours from the image, a filtering is needed, which is done by the size of the contours, and this is done by the checkLabel function. This function will determine if there is a label or not. This information now should be provided to the CODESYS. First, we need to get connected to the PLC, which is the virtual CODESYS PLC in this case. We should also activate Allow Anonymous Login in the Change Runtime Security policy to make the connection through OPC UA possible. As already mentioned, a symbol configuration is required, which is added to the project, and the variables to be exchanged through OPC UA are checked. You can see here that the variables in Python are using the exact names as the ones in the CODESYS, with a pass provided. The pass is obtained from the UaExpert application. That's a free application available from Unified Automation. As a first step in the UaExpert, we should get connected to the OPC server on CODESYS. After the connection is established, we have access to the variables which were selected in the symbol configuration. The pass, which is used in Python, is obtained from UaExpert. In Python, client is imported from the OPC UA library to create the connection to the OPC server. Connect to OPC UA function is used to connect to the server by providing the URL, which matches the name of the device as shown here. In this way, it will be possible to use Python to perform the computer vision and provide the result to CODESYS PLC to take proper action. I hope you have enjoyed watching this video. If you need more details regarding this project, you can contact me or the students directly. As always, don't forget to subscribe and suggest videos to your network. Thanks a lot for watching this video and see you next time. Bye for now.